Hey everybody, thanks so much for watching this video. Don't forget that it's brought to you by ChannelFireball.com, specifically the new U-Box We Buy program, the easiest way to sell your Magic cards online. It's as simple as taking your cards, boxing them up, and then shipping them over to Channel Fireball, where they'll take care of the rest, including sorting, pricing, and grading. Plus, they get you your money real fast. Head over to ChannelFireball.com/U-Box We Buy or click the link in the description below for more information. Thanks.
Yeah.
All right.
Come on.
One time? Hello? Yes!
Oh, nope.
Ooh. Yes! Let's go, Muxus!
Just hope for no Muxus.
Oh my god.
You know, easy game.
Bang!
Okay. Well. You know what? You know what? Just once upon a time.
Okay.
Fine. This is some nonsense, all right.
Oh my god, yes. All right.
Well, I guess we get everything today. All right. Welcome to match number 3, playing Goblins with Eli Goings. Did I say that right?
Yeah, Goings.
Perfect. Look, we've mulliganed these kind of hands for the most part. I'm down to mulligan this one too, just fine. Maybe like the London mulligans.
I like this hand, I'll say, because the thing that, so Goblins mulligan, so it's one drops a lot, but that's more true on the draw than on the play. And Mog War Marshal has a habit of making hands without one drops more keepable.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Because it basically accelerates your goblin count faster than most other things. And this hand is really nice in that it can go turn 1 basic, which is really important, turn 2 War Marshal, and then we have the choice of either playing a removal spell or being proactive and playing Pile Driver and Wastelanding.
Okay.
So it's actually like a pretty nice setup, and then we're only one red source away from a Chainmurler if this happens to be a matchup where Chainmurler is particularly good.
Very interesting. All right, I'll go ahead and keep it then. This one definitely seems like it's a hand built on grinding, so...
Yeah, so this is like a very, like, it's good in a fair matchup, and if it's an unfair matchup, the Wasteland's probably good. And it basically, this hand has a game plan, yeah. And that's what you're looking for with a Goblin's hand.
Okay, yeah, I actually really like that explanation. Game plan against...
Chainmurler's probably pretty good in this matchup.
Yeah, okay, double Memnite. Vault of Whispers. You know what card I'm thinking about right now? I mean, you're thinking about it too, right? I can't wait to board the Trash Master.
Yeah. So if you ask Max Gilmore about Steel Stompy versus Goblins, he maintains it is the deck's actual worst matchup.
Wow. Yeah. But Steel Stompy doesn't normally play like Memnite though, right? Like this seems more like Affinity than anything else.
Yeah, maybe. So I guess we'll just see what our draw step is.
Yeah, I think I actually want lands too. I'm going to take this main phase mm-hmm. 2 stop off because it's...
Yep.
Okay.
Oh, nice.
Okay. That's fine. Fine. It's palatable. Yeah, I think I'm just going to go Badlands and Mog War Marshal. I don't think I really want to play the Wasteland here.
Yeah, because it messes up our Chain Whirler curve if we draw the red source.
Yeah, and then I'm not even sure if they have Wasteland, but now that we have one Badlands in play, I'm really inclined to just fetch up another one.
That's reasonable, especially with double Expert in hand.
Yeah.
It's possible we were supposed to just pass with Expert up as well. That's reasonable.
Okay, yeah. You just kill one of the Memnites. That makes sense.
I mean, they might play like a Steel Overseer. Any number of things.
It's kind of crazy. I'm not going to lie. I the only deck that I can think of is Affinity, Cheerios. That's another one, but that deck...
Cheerios wouldn't play Vault of Whispers and Mistress.
Exactly, Cheerio. Yeah. Okay, so it is this.
Ravager. All right. That's not bad, actually.
Fine. We could actually just kill it right now, right? Like, flash in Munitions Expert? Never mind.
I mean, they'd have to sacrifice their land to do it. That's actually not pretty appealing to me.
What's up?
So, let's see. If we Expert it, then they have to sacrifice Memnite, Midnight, and Vault of Whispers, like...
To keep it alive?
Yeah, that's fine with me. So, let's see what we draw and then decide.
Not going to play the Echo Cost here. Mm-hmm. Goodbye, but we still get a 1/1, so things are fine. And then if we draw a Chain Whirler, maybe...
You mean Red Source?
Yeah, Red Source for Chain Whirler. Maybe that's still the play then, because the next turn we can just guarantee...
Yeah, I think that's still the play, yep.
Actually, wait, no, we don't actually guarantee it, do we?
Well, and then we'll have... No, we'll guarantee it, because then we can go Pile Driver plus munitions expert, and that'll be five goblins on board.
Yeah, that sells it. That sells it for sure. Okay.
It's also just a 3/3 first strike, which matches up really well against
a lot
what
of
they've got going
stuff.
On.
Yeah, exactly. All right, I don't know if I get punished here.
Third battle lens is nice because if we draw more red sources, we can double expert in the same turn.
Yeah. Okay.
I mean, I guess that would happen no matter what.
Oops, undo. All of these, add red, do the thing.
Moto skills.
I know, right? Gotta flex sometimes in the weirdest ways. Most of the times it's just like punting and missing the shot, but when you can deliver, you deliver, you know? Whoa. Okay, no, sorry. I thought they were sacking the Arcbound Ravager. I was like, what?
That would be something. Crater Maker is really good against Arcbound Ravager, I'll say.
That is true. That is absolutely true. If we draw Crater Maker next turn, we can just kill the Arcbound Ravager, and then if they try to offload the counters onto Mistress Factory, we can...
At Wasteland the Factory.
Yeah, surprise them with the Wasteland afterwards, so...
Yeah, we're in a really good spot.
Mm-hmm. Nice. I usually play decks that suffer against artifacts, so like Snow doesn't really have a good time against Steel Stompy or... what is it? The Urza Echo Stompy deck. Despite, you know, playing Oko and things like that, they just go a little bit too hard too fast and we don't have enough of it. This matchup, this deck, it's a nice change of pace to be able to just, you know, boom, hit him.
Red Source would be sick.
Matron. Okay, that doesn't seem like it does much here, but I think...
Let's see. So we're going to go...
So we still have the line for Pile Driver into Expert, right? That will kill the Arcbound Ravager.
Yeah, but I'm wondering if the Steel Overseer matters more.
Interesting. Okay, I see what you're saying. Because, well, then let's think about that. So then Arcbound becomes a 4/4. With the Vault, it becomes a 5/5. And if they activate Mistress Factory, then it's a 6/6. But we would have Goblin, 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 Pile Driver... is number 4, expert is number 5, and then the second expert would be number 6, so technically we could beat a 6/6. 7/7 is where things start to get a little bit nervous.
Well, it's also like, if the Ravager is just sitting there, I don't know, maybe we just, so the Ravager, if we kill the Ravager now, they move it over to the Steel Overseer, the Overseer becomes a 4/4, and then it can activate to push itself to a 5/5. When we can kill a 5/5 next turn. So I guess yeah, we do kill the Ravager here.
Okay.
They also missed their land drop. We could Wasteland the Factory.
Interesting. That's...
I think our mana matters more, though.
Yeah, especially since we have the Matron. I like that. Yeah.
Yep.
So
yeah.
I'll play the Pile Driver out here, and then... Yeah, that's actually kind of interesting observation. So this is one of the reasons why we actually would...
Oh, we can attack with Chain Whirler first.
We can?
It's first strike, yeah.
Don't they just make it a 4/4 then? Oh, we can. This is flash. Okay, yes. That's great.
Yeah, so it's pretty free attack.
Yeah. I think I'm telegraphing so hard here, but it's okay.
I mean, it doesn't matter. They can't call.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
So now we just kill the Ravager.
Yep. And Munitions Expert. This card seems to like have just like reinvigorated the archetype like so
it, it
much.
It made us much better in all of the fair matchups, basically.
Yeah.
Like cards that previously were really hard to get off the table. Like 4/4 creatures before turn 4, basically, were pretty hard to kill unless you had a like double Vial start or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
So big stuff, but also Planeswalkers like Liliana the Last Hope was just a nightmare. Before Munitions Expert got printed, it was just so hard to attack down. You basically needed to go like, they play Liliana, kill your thing, and then you go Warchief Pile Driver, kill Liliana. But that was like kind of the only setup you could do.
Yeah.
So this line is worse if they have a bunch of small artifact things to spit out here, and then they make it big. But that was a Stone Coil Serpent. All
right, that's fine. Right, we have a lot of mono colored creatures, so.
Expert doesn't kill it, which is relevant, but
yeah, but it's fine if they have 1/5/5. Like, I think we can handle that, right?
Oh yeah, we're fine.
So just draw this, another one. Okay, well, I'm going to go ahead and kill the Steel Overseer now.
Yes.
I don't think we get to attack though.
Maybe.
Oh, we've got Pile Driver. Okay.
Yeah, the Pile Driver might force a Yeah. Well, it's expert, the steel, and then count. It's a 9 power pile driver.
That is a lot of damage. And then we've got city. We can wasteland something here too. So actually, the more I think about it, yeah, I'm kind of in to just bash.
Yeah, if they block the chain whirler, they take what?
A lot.
11? 12? They take 12. And then we can just matron for Sling Gang and kill them.
Yeah.
In the next two turns.
Cool. All right.
Yeah.
Attack! Nice. I really like this. This is a feels good moment right here. Sure, you got a 5/5. I've got an army of goblins.
Never mind. I just received a word that we were playing against Jarvis and Dom last round.
Oh wow. that makes it even harder. Yeah. So
yeah.
Pat ourselves on the back.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so they do block here.
That's ambitious.
Interesting. I don't think they can combo kill us out of nowhere. I mean, I guess if they go like Ravager into Ballista.
Maybe we should wasteland them anyway. Just cut them off.
That's what I'm thinking. I'll just hit the City of Traders. I don't want to give them the mana. Like, maybe it makes sense to, because the city will naturally just die to itself, but I'd rather just not have to think about that.
Yeah, just minimize risk here, because we can still just matron, and then if we are drawing a land in the next two turns, we can still get chain world, Sling Gang. And if we don't draw land, we can just get a, what
did you call me? A crystalline giant? Okay.
Well, that dies to munitions expert, so
yeah,
I think
yes, it does. Okay. Okay, so I don't know what this symbol is. Reach. Okay, wait, really? That's interesting. I almost want to let this card survive so I could see what the other counters look like. but I think I will just pass. All right, we're going to go here, black, right. Red. Destroy the crystalline giant and then attack for lethal. Okay.
Exact lethal.
Yep. Calculated. Very nice. Okay, interesting.
Drawing all three experts pretty good against the opposing creature deck.
I think I agree. Yes, that makes a lot of sense. All right, let's think about sideboarding. So this in. These
oh, yeah.
in.
Oh,
this,
yeah.
This in.
Probably.
In. Probably. Yeah, probably. Probably. Okay, yeah.
Needle's probably pretty solid.
Like
Ravager and
too.
Overseer. Okay. All of our cards are good is the problem.
That is a very, I mean, it's a good problem to have, but it's a problem nonetheless, you know what I mean? So
I think ultimately pile drivers probably, we can probably just cut all the pile drivers in this matchup.
Really? It looks so good there, though.
Like, it was good in last game, but I think in post-board games, we're bringing in even more removal. Like, we don't need, basically what pile driver does in these sorts of matchups is that it's a, you try to use it as a forced terminate. Mm-hmm. That's how I think of it. So like whenever Eldrazi has to chump block with a Reality Smasher on my pile driver, that's how I'm using the pile driver.
I see.
But this matchup, they have enough. Like if they just make a Memnite a 2/2,
yeah,
it's trading down on
that's
mana.
Really bad. Yeah. Then pile driver doesn't look so good. That I think that's another way that you mentioned this to me before when we were playing is that Goblin Lackey is also kind of that card. It's designed to trade one for one more than it is to get a goblin into play. Like when it does, that's great. But like, it's kind of interesting how like goblins are like onions. They have layers, right? Like they do different things. And so just because it doesn't necessarily, I mean, like the actual intended purpose may be different than what is actually stated on the card. So that's kind of like an interesting way to think about it.
And then we can probably shave a Sling Gang. They don't have that much removal. So the second copy is a little bit redundant. Mm-hmm. And like obviously our life total is relevant, but I just don't think we need the second copy.
Sure.
We could shave a Muxus potentially, just from the logic of I don't think they can ever beat the first one.
Right. Also, this is kind of expensive, and I know that we could get one into play faster, but I think we're gonna be like, honestly, in this matchup, I would probably matron for Trashmaster before I matron for Muxus,
yeah.
Right? So like
yeah, I think we can play control like a slow grindy game against this deck more than almost any other deck because all of our cards are so potent as removal spells.
Yeah. All right. I'm comfortable with this. And then I'm trying to think, how good is the incinerator in this matchup? Still seems pretty fine, right?
It seems pretty good to me. Like it's something that's mono red, so it can kill a stone coil that expert can't.
That's a good point for sure.
And if they bring in, like, I mean, obviously they're not going to board in Trinisphere, but I have seen people leave in those kinds of effects post-board.
Seems so good to me, Eli. I'm going to have to ship this one back, but it's...
One land? This hand would be very good.
Yeah. Oh, because we do have, we even have the combo here, the Pashalic Mons Lieutenant.
Yeah, exactly. This hand's insane with one land, but...
Yeah. This one's not very good.
Unfortunate.
They did mulligan to six. I would normally be excited about like Goblin Lackey into Goblin Ringleader, but their deck literally is designed to put like, you know,
a bunch of things in.
Yeah,
this might be evil though, because the Lackey might at least force a standoff with the creature, and then we the Ringleader. And there's also a chance they mulligan to a hand that has Tarmogoyf Chalice, and we have Cavern for Lackey.
Okay, I'd be surprised if they kept Chalice in, but hopefully they do. Okay, yeah, I'm done. We could try it.
People usually leave in chalices on the play against goblins. I don't think they should, but mm-hmm. they do.
Okay. All right. We'll try this and see where it goes, and then I'm going to...
Ditch the fetch, I guess. I don't know.
Is that better than ditching the cavern?
Probably
I guess cavern
not.
Stops chalice, right? So.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, fetch. I'm just thinking if all the lands are equal, then life loss is a thing.
Okay. Seems reasonable to me. Plus, now we just...
And the thing about this hand is just, it has all good draws, right? There's not many bad draws.
Whoa. That is not expected. Ornithopter.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, I guess there's also another reality here, right? Which is if we draw into Munitions Expert...
Yeah, Expert's a very good draw.
That's pretty good. You mentioned this in the very beginning, like in the intro, right? Like Munitions Expert does have that 1-2 punch with Goblin Lackey to clear the way. Mm-hmm. Obviously, Ornithopter was definitely not like one of the cards that's on my radar for cards we want to like, you know, punch through, but it does see some play in Legacy, so.
Now in two Legacy decks.
Yeah. This and Ninjas. Ninjas.
So any of the mana, like, I think Port especially would be nice just to slow the game down to get to our Ringleader. Oh,
that's a little bit scary.
Now Expert's looking really important.
Really, really important. All right, deck, give it to me. What we got? Incinerator? Not exactly the same. Actually, that's fine, right? We get to attack here.
Yeah, we can trade. I mean, if they have a soul land, they can...
Do the thing.
Activate Factory and, yeah, get GT counters, but... I think we should take the trade with the Ornithopter as we can. We could also draw like a Pyrokinesis or something.
Yeah, all right. I'll just attack it on the end.
Oh, I guess it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
No, you can attack first and then play your land and cycle.
They're 100% going to block here, right? I think I want them to block.
No, we want to get the Ringleader in play.
You're right. I think I'd want them not to block. Sorry, typo. Gotta talk to production here. I don't know what the heck's going on nowadays. So here, I'll just go ahead and play the Mountain then. I don't think I need to.
Yeah, so City or Ancient Tomb is definitely the scary possibility here. But mm-hmm. if that happens, we still have all of our Creator Makers we can draw to blow up the GTA. Like, GTA connecting is not the end of the game.
One turn too short, but that's okay, too. Yeah, I also feel like if they had the Ancient Tomb, they probably would have led off of it anyway. So maybe that just like is a signal that they don't have it. That being said, like, obviously still want to be aware, cautious of that sort of thing, so... Now, this is a little bit awkward for us because any mana source that they play this turn at least allows them to activate the factory and pump the factory, so the Munitions Expert will not be able to really profitably block the factories.
What we could do if they start activating factory and then... it doesn't work. Never mind. I was thinking we could like flash an Expert and then block and then target itself, but that's not how that works.
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
Ballista on one. Okay, well, that's unfortunate.
Yeah, I mean, it's going to trade with the Lackey, which was looking like it wasn't going to trade with anything, so it's not too bad, actually.
Sure. Okay.
Port would be so good.
It really would. Or another one of these. Okay, that's fine. I'll take that.
That's actually very, very good.
Yeah. And then do...
Yep.
This, and then I'll probably just drop another Cavern. I don't think I want the... I don't want the Badlands to get wasted, so. Cool. All right, just make them have it.
Yeah, now if they go for a GTA equip attack, then we'd get the blowout.
Mm-hmm. Looking forward to that 100%. Jankophile, do I have your number? We'll see. I don't think they drew another land. I think that's the first thing that they would have done. They would have slammed it into play there, so.
That sounds correct to me.
Yeah. Which means we do get to connect. We get to put Ringleader into play, and then life is pretty good from there.
They can tap the factory and make it a 3-3 unblock, so we can't. We can trade Lackey with a factory. We can't necessarily connect.
Oh. That's exactly what I was saying like 2 seconds ago, and I like instantly forgot. Big yikes.
Port Needle or Wasteland would let us connect, though. Or Bolt.
Ooh, Ravager?
That's okay. Good. That's great for us.
Yeah, that's great. All right. One munitions expert coming in on the end step. Hot. Hot. Actually, they have a lot. They had a lot of it. Right? The bottleneck for them was definitely mana, right? Arcbound Ravager, Walking Ballista is actually like a terrifying combination of cards. So,
yeah, at that point, you need to draw your actual shatters pretty quickly.
Mm-hmm. All right, so I'm gonna use this. Do this.
Hey, do you think they'll sacrifice their Jitte to make it a 2-2?
Oh my goodness! Well, I would hope not. That would not be a good look for them. But yeah, we'll use the Munitions Expert here. Deal the damage. I mean, we actually made it to turn 4, so technically we could just double Ringleader here, but I think I just want to actually...
Oh, man. Double Ringleader sounds really good.
Yeah. There might be merit to actually... Yeah, I think we should just play a pre-combat, right? Because it's only upside.
If we hit Trashmaster, we, like, win on the spot. If we hit a Sacrifice Outlet, we can fog the Jitte no matter what, basically.
Mm-hmm.
And if we hit nothing, then we can just put in the second Ringleader.
Yeah, okay.
We could also hit Muxus and win.
We also could hit Muxus. Okay, we hit Crater. Yeah, we did it. Okay, that's great. That is excellent. We hit pretty well here. So
yeah, I think we just attack with everything and then Matron for Trashmaster.
Seems good. Is that better than putting the Skirk Prospector into play?
If they have some sort of larger creature next turn, like, I really don't think we care if they go soul land equip Jitte attack.
Sure.
Like, I just don't think that matters.
Trashmaster too, like, they, good.
Yeah, that we play Trashmaster and then they kill Lackey, kill expert, we attack for 5.
Yeah,
and then
okay.
So then we're just like, can't die.
They look very dead in this spot. Yeah, I agree. They've got 3 cards in hand, none of which are lands, so
yeah, I don't think they can get out of this.
And the Jitte will be forced to take down the Lackey because otherwise we'll we'll just put more scary creatures into play. So that's pretty good, all in all. All right, yeah. Nice. We just need to go through the motions, and then we've got it.
This finally is also a nice quick one.
yeah, exactly, right? The first two were just like kind of a slog, and now we get to rest and relax. So this is an artifact creature, right? It is. Okay.
Yeah, you can just shatter factories if they activate.
Yeah.
Yeah, Shatterstorm Lord is pretty nuts.
All right, that's Ballista. That's fine.
That is so fine.
Okay. Also fine. Untap. And what do we get? Aether Vial. Honestly, that's not even crazy good here. So I probably would just
Trashmaster pre-combat and then attack for a lot, and then we can play Skirk.
Mm-hmm. Oh, man. And then can't be countered. It's also a Lord, so we get to attack for a giant chunk of damage. We don't have any cost reduction, so I actually don't think it's worth it to like play the Skirk and then try to get like the Crater Maker or something like that into play. We could just
do... Yeah, there's just no reason.
Yeah. Plus, now that this is in play, it's just like, you know.
We could make mostly random game actions, so the rest of the game, I'm pretty sure we couldn't lose.
I almost want to try it. No, I'm just kidding. F6 passed the turn.
Interaction that I doubt that you've seen, but I've pulled off a couple times is you can use Goblin Trashmaster to shatter your own things with Pashlik Mons in play, and you can hold priority to repeatedly do it. So, like, you've won Aether Vial, but you can just shatter, hold priority.
Oh, that's cool. Yeah, just to get some damage triggers off of Pashlik Mons.
I did that to beat a moat effect once.
Ah, all right. I like that. I like that a lot. All right, match number 3 in the books. See you for the next one. Match number 4. Guys, don't forget, if you want to catch me live, you can check out my stream, twitch.tv/unzidmtg. Also, follow me on Twitter, same handle. We are going to keep this one. This one looks pretty good. Vile, Crater Maker, Expert. I like it.
Yeah, this is a great hand against like a Delver deck, which we haven't seen so far. Basically any creature deck. And even against a combo, we've got a Wasteland and a reasonable clock.
Yep. Scalding Tarn, good sign.
All right.
So let me ask you a question. Scalding Tarn, oh, that's pretty good too. I kind of want to just jam Mountain Vial. Now, obviously...
I 100% agree.
yeah, I'm thinking like, look, they could have something like Daze here, but...
It sucks. Daze I'm fine with. It sucks specifically against like a Spell Pierce. Oh, Snap Resolve, we're good.
Okay. I appreciate this opponent. Now we're going to go to... I mean, they could have like Show and Tell, and it could be pretty gruesome.
Well, we actually have... We have Show and Tell Emrakul covered. We don't have Grizzlebrand covered, but we will in the next couple of turns because the Sling Gang will probably, if we get a couple points of damage on them, the Sling Gang could make it so that Grizzlebrand isn't allowed to draw cards. Mountain. Whoa. Oh, is this our best matchup? Oh, is this Trinis? Oh, Imperial. Oh, is this Painter?
Painter. Okay, that's interesting. Imperial Recruiter. All right.
I was excited it was Moonstompy for a second, but that
matchup does seem pretty good, actually. Moonstompy.
Almost unlosable.
Yeah, something about creatures. Oh, Goblin Engineer. Okay, wait, that's not allowed. We're the Goblin Tribe here.
Yeah.
All right. This
Jump Palm's gonna be quite good in this matchup because it counts all goblins.
Okay. Yeah. Use Aether Visibility. I would love to. I'm kind of nervous about like a Karn coming up next turn.
I think we Wasteland them then.
That's what I was gonna say. And so for that reason, I don't mind Wastelanding here. City of Traders, again, like here's the thing, right? Sometimes it's actually correct to Wasteland City of Traders if I'm trying to keep them off a volume of mana, even though City of Traders doesn't have like the what is it called? Like the longevity. I think in this sort of situation, we're also able to capitalize on this because we've got our own thing ticking up here, Aether Vial. We're generating mana in the meantime, and then we're also just cutting them off something that's super scary, like exactly Karn or just a fast combo, right?
So if next turn they go Goblin Engineer, then we can Violin, Crater Maker, and cast Expert and kill the Engineer.
Yep. Okay. I like that. And then paint. Then we can keep the Crater Maker around to...
Crater Maker specifically does not interact well against Painter Servant because it's colorless non-land permanent and Painter makes everything have a color.
Ah, all right. Well, I did not realize that. That is... No, I if I thought about it, I'd figure it out, but good point. Good point. All right, here. So I'm going to untap, upkeep, do this, and then draw, and then Bloodstained Mire is pretty solid here.
Yeah. All right. Let's kill that Engineer immediately, I think. Mm-hmm. And if they play a Painter next turn, we can Matron for either Gem Palm or another Expert to kill it.
Okay, so Vial in this. And then Vial. We'll flash this or hardcast.
If that was a Painter, and I mean, it's kind of, it would be different numbers, but technically speaking, I think we're supposed to Vial in the Munitions Expert then because of like a Spirit Guide into Pyroblast, but obviously they don't have Painter in play yet, but that's something to keep in mind for future turns.
Interesting. Okay. That's like a real small thing, you know what I'm saying? Like edges.
Spirit Guide too many times to not be very particular about that kind of thing.
No. And like the thing is like that's the important thing, right? Like, and that's why I'm glad that you're here, because you actually know all this stuff, and me, I'm just like sort of minding my own business. But okay, another Imperial Recruiter.
Make sure for Chain Whirler is about to look really appealing.
Yeah, I could definitely
see. I feel like they're gonna get Goblin Welder.
Oh, please do. Please make my day here. Goblin Welder would be very sick.
I don't know if we would even do that, though. Because if they go Painter, Grindstone, Activate, they can kill us. We might need to just hold up removal.
Okay.
I don't know, though. They'll have three, up to four cards.
While going up to three is going to be pretty good for us, though, for sure, I think. I like the...
Yeah. Something that's secretly good in this matchup, if they have Painter in play, Piledriver often becomes insane because of their main deck Blast. They almost always name blue, so it becomes a Progenitus.
Oh my goodness. Wait, they're actually gonna... they didn't put it into play. Interesting.
Huh. What does that mean?
I don't know. Yeah, I'm about as confused as you are. I mean, I'm still gonna tick up here on the.
Oh yeah. They have Bolt main maybe.
That's a reasonable card to play around here. Okay, upkeep, and we draw. Mountain, okay, that's fine. So we could Matron here for something cool.
So we have to consider, how do we lose here?
Right.
I think it would involve them playing the full combo next turn.
Which they could, right?
Yeah, they have a land, yeah. So I think we should not play the Pile Driver yet.
Mm-hmm.
Because we want to hold up Matron for Gem Palm or Expert.
Sure, I like that. Yeah.
So I think we just go land, go. I guess we can attack with the Munitions Expert, I think. Maybe not. Because the body on board has value.
I agree.
This link.
I think I want to just keep it in my hand, keep it in play right now. I'm down to just pass here.
The thing is, though, is like clearing the board for Pile Driver could be relevant as well.
Okay.
But it's kind of a close call. I think we should hold back, though. They probably wouldn't block, but it's kind of bad for us if they do.
Yeah. All right. I'm just going to assume that we have I don't know. Maybe 1 point of damage could end up mattering. Let's see if it does or doesn't. But I definitely do like the discipline here, which is just, you know, keep the Matron. Matron represents Incinerate. Okay, they do have Lightning Bolt, right. So
let's take out that Recruiter for free.
Deal. I'm going to get this one because it's not summoning sick.
Fetch now.
Interesting.
Just so that we don't have to fetch in between our Matron tutoring.
Sure. What's nice here is I can actually pick up the Badlands without having to worry. Like, even if they do Blood Moon, like, haha, we're base red anyways, so.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to ask another question here. So let's say we, like, you know, Vial in the Matron. What do you want to pick up off this Matron? I mean, obviously, Gem Palm or Munitions Expert seems pretty good.
Yeah, it really depends on what they do here.
Sure. Servant, okay.
Sure.
So Munitions Expert is... Okay, well... And this is the Welder.
Is the name blue? Yeah. So this is fine.
Actually, now that I think about it, they probably have Pyroblast as their last card, right?
That would make sense. So they don't have the combo.
Mm-hmm.
Man, I wish we had a Trash Master in our main deck.
I think I'm definitely just gonna activate this though, anyways.
Mm-hmm.
We're not gonna not put the Matron into play here. Yes.
Yeah.
Do this. Okay.
I think we get Gem Palm because it's uncounterable. Well, we could get Chain Whirler and kill the Welder because they don't have Grindstone in hand. Pretty.
Yeah. Is it crazy to pick up another Matron here?
No, it's not. That's pretty reasonable. It gives us more decision points on our next turn. If we draw a War Chief and we could Vial that in, that could potentially just kill them.
Okay.
I guess they could Pyroblast the Pile Driver on the stack.
Well, this is really messing with me. And is it Muxus? Wow. All right. Thank you, Painter Servant, I guess.
I think the kill priority probably is the Welder. We could get Gem Palm and just Gem Palm it right now, and they can't do anything about it. And that gives us an extra card and tells us what to do, basically, with the Vial.
Yeah. Actually, I like that more now that I think about it, because I do agree with you that the Welder is the most dangerous card here, even though they have Painter Servant in play, and it's highly likely that they have Pyroblast in their hand, right?
Yeah, I agree.
Okay. So what is it? Gem Palm Incinerator right here.
So Gem Palm's quite nice, and then it gets around counter spells.
Yeah, for sure. Which is why it's not completely cut from the deck, right? Like, Munitions Expert is super good, but...
There's a lot of niche situations where Gem Palm is just way better.
Yeah.
And this is one of them.
All right, we're going to kill the... Actually, how crazy
is
it?
We could kill the
painter. That is
but
true.
If they pyroblast a goblin, then it doesn't work.
Yeah, all right, we're going to go for this then. I did not realize, but yeah, goblin, you mentioned this before, yes. Goblins will add up to the incinerator count, so... All right, what do we draw here? A Ringleader.
All right, well, Vial's going to 4.
Yeah, that looks like it. Okay. Yes. And that's a Crater Maker. Not exactly it. I guess I'm just going to flash in the Ringleader here.
Mm-hmm. If we hit another Expert, then we're really golden.
Yep. Use Aether Vial's ability. Yes, I'd like to put in Goblin Ringleader. Give me the money. All right, well, that's a Chain Whirler. That's not the worst here.
Yeah. So I think we can attack.
I would like to attack. I'll just attack with the Ringleader, though.
No, I think we can attack with everything because if they block a 1-1 with the Painter, mm-hmm. then we can Crater Maker the Painter. And if they Pyre Blast the Crater Maker, then the Pile Driver resolves.
Okay. Yeah. Sure. Yeah, that makes sense. That's a little sneaky. I like that. And that's kind of cool too, right? Like you're making a plan, and if that plan doesn't work, then you have another plan, and if that doesn't work, then you have another plan, kind of deal. Which is that's good. I like that.
And they know about the Crater Maker in the hand, so they probably can't really. Like they might block with the Recruiter.
Mm-hmm. Oh, they're blocking.
Oh. Okay.
Okay. All right. That's also good.
I guess that they're incentivized to block with the Recruiter because of they know about the Chain Whirler.
Yeah. Damage. Right, so okay.
Now we get to see.
You gotta have Pyre Blast here, right?
Maybe their last card is Grindstone.
No, okay, it is Pyre Blast. That makes sense here. And all then right. That's fine. Here comes the heat.
All right, so they need to draw. They need to draw Grindstone this turn.
Mm-hmm. Well, I don't want them to.
Yeah.
Okay.
Pile Driver swings. We attack him for 5, and we play Chain Whirler. Put 6. I think we actually have. Are we 1 short? Oh no. Maybe.
So yeah, you said attack for 5, and then 6, and then 7, 8, 9, 10, 11.
Well, the Chain Whirler picks them for 1.
Smuggler's Copter.
Smuggler's Copter.
Okay, that's exciting. This is another matchup where Trashmaster is going to be very good.
Yeah, it's going to be really good. I think we're good here, though, because if they block with either of their creatures, the Chain Whirler will finish it off.
Mm-hmm. Use Aether Vial's ability. No, thank you. I would like not to. I always get nervous about that mountain. Okay, that's not exactly it.
All right, swing to attack.
Yeah, so we just attack with these two and then see how they block.
Yep.
I think they're actually... Well, oh, yeah, I guess... I think here... Well, they get to loot, technically, but...
I think we have them dead no matter what, because even if they can... Grindstone combo us, they have to tap the tomb.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
And we would be able to kill them... like before we drew a card.
Okay. I think I'm just going to play this out right now, though.
Yeah. Wait, is this not lethal? Am I missing something? Or they go to 1?
So they're at 7 after we play the Chain Whirler. Okay, that's 3 goblins in play. And then we play the Siege Gang with off the Vial.
Yep, it's 1 short.
But I still do this, I think, because then this will turn off the fetch as well, right?
Exactly, yep. So they only effectively have 2 mana, and they can't do anything scary with 2 mana here.
Yeah, I'll just play this out. Sure.
Pretend we have Munitions Expert as a last card.
Yeah. I guess the... If they draw... Okay, I just kill them here, right?
Yeah. Yeah, there's nothing they can do.
Nice. Okay.
Goblin Tendrils.
Oh, goodness. Oh,
it kind of is.
But it is, though. Yeah, you're right.
Storm count is equal to the number of goblins who are alive thus far.
Mm-hmm. All right. I think we stole this game. Yeah, and they're going to concede here. Nice. This is the power of the Siege Gang Lieutenant. Let's take a look at the sideboard, though. Ooh, I like this.
Yeah, Relic is great. Trashmaster is A+. Pyrokinesis is very good.
Okay.
The thing that I normally do against a Painter is I don't board in Graveyard Hate most of the time.
Mm-hmm.
So I would not board in the Relics. The Relic gets worse because of Karn.
Okay.
And also, I just, the welders and the engineers are the effects we're best interacting with anyway. So I feel like it hedges towards the wrong side of things, you know?
Okay. So we are what, soft against like just like the turn two painter, turn three combo, yep. Or turn one painter, even if they've got double ancient tomb kind of deal?
Exactly. And pyrokinesis is really good at blowing out fast painter kills.
I like that. How do you feel about this card? Okay, reasonable. I like that.
Yeah, they have Bolt and Blast. They should board out Blast. Not every player does, but they should.
Mm-hmm.
Because of that interaction with Pile Driver is just really rough for them.
Yeah,
I think.
Plus like we have our own Pyro Blast. Worst case scenario, we could...
Yeah, some people do that.
Yeah.
But I think it's like 50-50 of Painter players naming blue post-board or not. So I just wouldn't hedge that way. I think this is a matchup we can shave on Muxus. I think the way to think about this is if we get a functional hand,
mm-hmm.
we're favored, right? So we just don't want to expose ourselves to high variance cards.
Yeah, that's a really good way of thinking about it.
So we can shave a Muxus, we can shave a Sling Gang. And I almost want... I mean, we can assume there's Karn in their deck, right?
I would be so surprised if they don't have Karn. Karn just seems like it fits slots in so nicely that...
So in which case, I think I'd shave a Vial.
Okay.
You don't really want to draw multiples. Mm-hmm. And then we can shave... Let's shave a Ringleader and a Pile Driver.
Okay. Seems pretty good. Yeah, I mean, my thought is I am also comfortable. I know it seems weird to cut like Aether Vial against the... In a tribal deck, right? But Karn the Great Creator just makes that card so horribly like unplayable. I mean, you could still attack the Karn.
Vial, I mean, we can Creator Maker Karn most relevantly.
Mm-hmm.
But the thing is you just don't want your Sand Solid. You don't want to draw multiple Vials when you're trying to deal with Karn. That is really the issue. Like if you have one, it's fine. It still ticks up, and then you Creator Maker it, and now your Vial is online. But it can be pretty devastating if you got two and get really stuck.
Interesting. How often do people board in like Null Rod effects against you?
Pretty often. Okay. I don't think they really should.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe like Rug Delver should, because I'm also boarding in Relic and they are really soft to Vial. But it is quite bad against Crater Maker, and it is a 2-mana that will only affect like us like 6 copies. You know, it only has 6 targets.
Yeah.
So it's pretty medium, I consider.
Okay, so here's the mountain. There's the Goblin Welder. I'm cool with that. Turn one, Badlands,
Goblin Lockie.
Yeah. And then we fire off the incinerator to kill the welder. Seems like a nice curve to me. Yeah. Oh, thank you.
My God.
Don't mind right, if this I Lockie, do.
If this Lockie gets into play, things are about to get
nasty. Yeah. Exactly, right? 4 mana, who needs that? We've got the greatest mana accelerant of all time right here. Let's go. Goblin Lackey. What's your turn two, Eddie? What you got? Okay.
The best thing is if they play a Goblin Engineer, okay, nice. That's fine.
Okay.
So we can incinerate that, and then if we draw another mule spell, then we'll probably trade with the welder.
Mm-hmm.
So that just keeps the board clear, and we're up a card. Pyrokinesis, best draw by a mile.
Oh, yeah. And this is what I'm talking about, right? Like, all of these matchups where it's like, all right, they want to use, like, a creature to block, and I'm just like, and if we find the Pyrokinesis, they just die on the spot. You know what I mean?
And wow, that's...
Snaring Bridge.
That is not that good.
I'm content with that. Yeah. Oh, okay, well, yes. I don't mind if I do 3 damage to this, 1 damage to this. Okay. And then here, I think I want to pitch the Pile Driver.
Yeah, Pile Driver. We have enough of a clock with the War Marshal and the Trash Master. That's just so much damage. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Very nice. Very, very nice. And then we even get to upkeep port them, which is...
I think we get the War Marshal in play.
Okay, that works too.
Because if they play an artifact, we can shatter it for free
mm-hmm.
before the Marshal dies.
Oh, yeah, so it's almost like they're time-walked here, yeah.
and then it keeps it from being summoning sick.
Yeah. Super nice. And we get the 2/2s, so this is pretty great. All right.
That was such a good draw.
Yeah. Trashmaster MVP. What it do, baby? Let's go.
Affectionately in the Goblin community, he's known as Shrek, Danny DeVito, because the trash man from Always Sunny.
Yeah. That's adorable. I like that. Yeah. Legacy community is great. Shout out to the Legacy Goblins community too. What's up?
The people of the Goblins community love the deck with a pretty serious amount of just power.
Yeah.
Oh, poor opponent. They're rip.
I was supposed to sack that on their end step. Whoops.
We can't. There's no targets.
Oh, yes. I was not supposed to sack that on their end step. Whoops. All good. We get this, untap. Okay, Crater Maker's pretty good too. I'm gonna start with an attack first.
They need Bolt here.
Yeah, that would be the out here. I almost wonder if I'm just supposed to port them. I think I really am.
Just put in Pashalik and port them.
Mm-hmm. And then upkeep, port. I don't know, man. Maybe I should go for this one. All right.
Nice. Just be the one on the left.
Misplay. Punt. All right. But now they look pretty dead, right? Like, oh, we could do the thing that you were talking about, right?
Could, but we don't have to because we actually have exact lethal on the table. We have 12.
2 + 3 = 5. +2 + 2 = 9. Oh, yeah, you're right. That is exactly lethal. All right. Facts.
Like, got it. I don't see how they got.
Never didn't have it. Goblin Lackey showing why it's the meanest in the streets. Trashmaster also definitely overperforming. Guys, we'll see you for the fifth and final match in just a little bit. Stay tuned. All right, match number 5, the final match of the league. Before we begin, don't forget, today's video is brought to you by ChannelFireball.com. Check out CFB Pro for the latest and greatest that they've got to offer. This hand seems pretty good. I'm going to go ahead and keep this here. We've got the turn 1 Skirk Prospector. We've got the turn 2 Munitions Expert. Okay, well... Snow-covered island preordained.
So many things.
It could be so many things, right? It could be Dreadhorde Arcanist on turn 2. It could be Show and Tell on turn 2. I think we still lead with our best foot forward, which is just Mountain Skirk Prospector.
Yep.
We'll see what they've got here. They did go bottom, which is not a bad sign for us. And they paused on the Skirk Prospector, which I think there might be a daze, but you never know.
A daze doesn't even necessarily mean Delver, because it could also just be Show and Tell still.
Okay, that's true. All right, well.
Whoa.
Wow.
Whoa.
This all escalated quickly.
Wow, old school.
Yeah. So I guess Stoneforge Mystic actually got kind of leveled up here as of late because of Shark Typhoon. That card has certainly been pretty good for...
Let's just expert that Forge ASAP.
Yeah. And then I'm just going to go Badlands. I wish we had a Cavern here. Cavern is definitely just ridiculously good in this matchup, but...
If they force this, it's not the end of the world, because then we'll get to resolve our Matron to get a Creator Maker for the sword.
Okay. It's pretty good, yeah. Unfortunately, next turn we can't Matron and Munitions Expert. Like, we can't tutor up the Matron, the Expert with the Matron, because... Yeah, we won't have Black, so...
Well, I mean, we probably don't have to kill anything next turn, right?
I was just thinking, like, if this got forced.
Oh, sure, yeah.
All right, goodbye, Stoneforge Mystic.
That long pause makes me think they do have a force.
Yeah, it's really interesting. I mean, like, I'm surprised. Like, they just didn't do anything about it. I guess, that is a good point, though. Crater Maker for the main deck anti-artifact hate is very good. The Sword of Fire and Ice probably won't be as threatening as it...
It's almost even weird to see Sword of Fire and Ice in Stoneblade main deck. That's kind of fallen out of fashion.
Yeah. I think the trendy thing nowadays is like sort of Feast and Famine, but Sword of Fire and Ice is still pretty good here. What is this? Oh, okay. Sword of Fire and Ice. Yeah.
That's actually really good for us. The most annoying thing about equipment is when they just let them sit in hand for a while, because then it's harder to set up the Crater Maker. Cavern, please.
That's okay. It's not bad.
I think we fetch out Mountain because of back to basics existing.
Yep. I'm a huge
fan. I'm actually, it's not crazy to just sack expert and play ringleader, but given that we think they probably have a force, we don't want to give up board position. So I think we just matron for our shatter.
Yep, I'm happy with that for sure. I guess the ultimate downside would be if they did something crazy like play True Name Nemesis and have Force of Will.
Yeah, that'd be the worst case.
Wow. Okay, that is respectable. Right. I definitely understand that.
All right.
So they did go Force Pitch Force.
Wait. Sure, but then we're going to resolve Ringleader next turn, and hopefully that'll draw us either another Matron or one of our three Crater Makers.
Yeah. Pretty content with that.
Mm-hmm.
They might actually just be holding up something like Shark Typhoon this turn, so that's something that we want to be conscious about. Okay, another Matron. That's pretty good, actually, I think.
We could Matron for Incinerator and hold that up.
That's
because Shark would be a 2-2, right?
It would be a 2-2, yeah.
So that would work.
I'm actually very fond of that play. I think I like that a lot.
We could attack first, and if they cycle and block, we can Chain Whirler the Shark and preserve our Matron. That's probably better.
Okay.
Because we lose our Skirk, but I don't think that's a huge deal.
Yeah. All right. I'll play the Wasteland post-combat. I don't think it's going to matter too much. They're doing a pretty good job of just like having access to non-basics. I locked in there. I had to double down, you know what I'm saying? So, but now that they've done this, I'm a little bit nervous, and I would like to play the Wasteland into Matron just to stop the Shark from connecting with this thing. Do you think that's... what do you think about that?
Yeah. It's just not tutoring for the direct answer to the sword might make us lose a longer game.
Okay.
But given that we have Ringleader and Sling Gang, stopping one sword attack might be all we need. So... yeah, I think we can Matron for Incinerator.
Interesting. Well, I actually like that you're thinking about, you know, what happens if it fails, or like what we want to be doing. Like, what if the... oh, interesting.
Okay. Maybe they're cycling now to try to find a force?
Yeah, something like that. In this matchup, Cavern of Souls would have been so good if we had it early.
Yeah.
Wow. You definitely don't see that one every day.
Whoa. All right, that is rough.
Yeah, that is kind of the blowout here. Venser is going to bounce the Matron. Oh,
punished
man.
For attacking, I guess.
Yeah. Wait, really? How?
Well, because we could block Venser and sacrifice. Oh, no, it's not.
Yeah, I guess they got a pro red, so it's like, it's a wash, I guess.
Can't get Sling Gang into play, so yeah, I think this just... I mean, we could sack our stuff and play Matron again and get the Crater Maker.
Mm-hmm. Is that worth it?
Well, it might be, because if we don't do that, then they sword kill the Skirk, and then we can't Matron for Crater Maker and activate Crater Maker.
I like that. Okay, that you sold me. Add this, sack this.
Mm-hmm.
Sack this, click here, do this, okay. Calculus later, and we've got Goblin Matron back in play.
So they got some good value off that, but we are mostly fine on value considering what our hand looks like.
Yeah, our hand is actually extremely strong right now. I'm pretty satisfied with it. The Venser was just like, it's not something that was on my radar. That card is certainly...
I guess Cavern is less good against Venser.
Yeah, exactly. That's another thing to think about too. So, sure.
Mm-hmm.
One thing to think about is like, what if they have like Caracas? But we've got Wasteland for that at some point of the time. Okay, so they're going after the Matron. I think I'm okay with that.
Yeah. We just really need to dodge another force here, or we need to draw Cavern.
Yeah.
All right. Well, they've already pitched two forces. They're two forces down, so they have to find a two of.
Exactly. Yeah, so I don't think it's, like, crazy, our situation. But,
yeah. All right.
All right, they went Ponder, no Shuffle. Well, didn't really find what we were looking for.
Happy to draw land, though.
Yeah, I think I'm just going to play the Crater Maker off the Wasteland here. Actually... yep.
I mean, we can avoid tapping all non-basics, I guess. Because we have five mana, so we're not going to cast anything else this turn.
Mm-hmm. All right, I'm just gonna do that then and see what happens.
Yeah.
Like worst case scenario, if they do like plow in response to something, like that's fine. Am I crazy? Is it crazy to just get another Badlands? No, I'm gonna get the mountain.
Yeah, mountain. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I think actually we should have tapped the wasteland because if they forced, we would want to play the chain roller.
Okay.
Yeah.
Fortunately, not punished, but I guess we get to just pass the turn here and then.
If I mean, I guess we should shatter right now on the random chance that they have a stifle in the deck.
I was just about to say, like, if my opponent has stifle, so be it. They have outplayed me, but
there's just no reason not to do it right now because it's gonna be a forced play.
Mm-hmm. We can't block anyways, right? Like the upside would be if we could like block, you know, and then sack shatter, but
yep,
not an actual thing here. So you're right. Just play around it. I mean, stifle is kind of on the uptick, right? There are a couple decks in the format that are a couple fair decks, in fact, that are.
I blame you for that one.
Oh God, no. I mean, I know the people. Okay, all right. Well, Ponder is gonna resolve here.
Six.
Yeah.
This game could go long, so we want to maximize our clock.
Yep, seems good.
So, but I mean, now that the Sword of Fire and Ice is gone, that is their most potent threat. And since we have Sling Gang in hand as life gain, it's pretty hard for them to aggro us out with true names. Like they're at 12. We're gonna get to. We have Ringleader to reload, so we're probably going to play Ringleader next turn. Hopefully we draw either, I think we're open to just draw land next turn so we can go Ringleader into two drop.
Yep. Wow, okay, they went Ponder no shuffle again.
Smells like true name. No, okay.
Yeah, I'm
Oh, wow. I think this is fine.
I think so too. Cuz
if they take the Ringleader, then we get a redraw, and then we can just Chain Whirler and kill the V-Click for free.
I'm content with this. So this is some sort of like Legends Blade dot deck. Do we want to kill the Venser immediately? I kind of want to, just because Caracas is a little bit... Oh, but we don't have the mana for it. Okay, never mind.
Yeah, it depends on if we drew a land. Like.
Okay. So then the other thing to think about is... If they don't take the Ringleader, do we just play the Ringleader?
Probably.
Yeah. Their clock is a little bit scary. 5 points of power. We're at 12. I mean, they haven't cast a single Swords to Plowshares this game. And I don't know. This is just like, it's a little bit wacky, right? Because they're not drawing into lands, so they must have a couple removal spells, but they're also not, do they really have another force?
They haven't brainstormed yet, so they could have stuff like Spell Pierce or otherwise just totally offline cards and hand, like Force Negation.
Yeah. Do you think they potentially kept this click off of the Ponder? Like, I gotta wonder, right? Like, if you've got dead cards in your hand, you're not developing your mana. Maybe you just don't need to develop your mana in this situation if you can cast all your spells in your hand. Like, that's totally reasonable.
Yeah. It's a little hard to... I would assume they've got a plow here. Ah, they took a Chain Whirler. Okay. We drew a Crater Maker. That's pretty solid.
Yeah. Honestly, we could just kill their squad right now, right?
Yeah, we could. We could kill both. I don't even hate that. It's a little bad against, like, a Jace.
True.
I think I'm okay leaving the Venser in play. The click has flying, so I'm a little more scared of it.
Okay. So you're suggesting that we maybe like a Crater Maker, Munitions Expert, and then just leave the Venser, but Munitions Expert the Vendilion click.
That's what I think so.
Do we even need to play the Crater Maker then?
Probably.
We're not going to do anything with our mana, right?
Yeah, we're not going to use our mana. And if they plow it, we're going to have one mana open, so then we can just kill the Venser.
Okay. In that case, I think I just like lead on this.
It gives them less info.
Yeah. All right. Goodbye, Vendilion click. Yes. Play that. So the reason I would want to do this right now is because of Caracas.
I don't think they have it.
I think the tell is that they pondered twice and they still didn't have it. So unless it's exactly on top of their deck, I think we're fine.
Yeah.
But we've also got Wasteland, so it's like maybe Caracas isn't.
Yeah, it just said. Scary. If the Caracas, they're Venser, then we just create a make it in response, right?
True. Okay. Yeah, that's fine. That's pretty reasonable. I also don't care about the damage, I don't think, in this situation. They could like play true name or something like that, but
yeah, true name, we'd swing it. We'd love to draw a pile driver. Pile driver would just be super, super nice.
I agree. Yeah. Interestingly enough, I feel like they might have one sword to plashers that they're just like holding on to, you know what I mean?
Yeah, if they pull out pile driver, the sling gang might stick around, and the sling gang's probably gonna generate more damage overall.
There's the true name.
Sure.
Alright, this card is manageable with Crater Maker in play. Like, okay, yeah. So the combat does get a little bit tricky, but like we're not worried about True Name getting suited up and then doing scary things, you know?
Yeah, exactly. Cavern, please. Oh.
Okay, you've got to be very quiet about this. I don't want them to know that we top deck this card, okay? I'm just going to go Ringleader here, I think, then.
Yeah, I think we can tap the Wasteland because we probably don't play a one drop. We probably want to hold up Crater Maker, but we'll see.
Yeah. Nice.
Oh, wow. Oh, wow. Uh-huh. Lackey's not bad because...
There's a lot of things. We first of all, we've assembled the 1-2 punch. Then we've also got this.
Yeah.
It's just basically GT, right?
Yeah, and if they have plow, they can plow now and then GT, and all we would be giving up is killing the Venser.
This is a factual statement. How bad is GT for us anyways, though, in this situation?
Not that bad if we draw a land.
Okay, yeah. All right, I mean, so you want to play the Goblin Lackey too?
Yeah, I think it might force them to just sit back,
yeah,
which is really appealing. Or if it eats a plow, which is also very appealing, because our hand has three targets that demand plows. Seems plus good. The Crater Maker on board.
Yeah. Imagine if Munitions Expert could target players' life totals. Oh, my goodness.
So broken. Just yeah.
All right, there's another planes here. Makes sense. Whoa.
So this might be GTA. This also could be Batterskull. That would be bad.
Batterskull would be... Yeah, Voltron is not something that I want them to have in play. But if they, I guess if they have like land into Stoneforge into GTA or some weird stuff like that, like...
Yeah.
Ugh, okay, that's... Kind of unexpected. So they've got Sword of Fire and Ice, Sword of Feast and Famine.
I wonder if they're not playing GTA.
Yeah. Yeah, that would be kind of crazy, right?
So I guess we got punished for playing out our Crater Maker, but
yeah, it's fine. I'm gonna get rid of the This card does not seem like it's gonna be doing too much, and this does make them have to have exactly something else here.
Hardcast Force would be annoying.
It would.
Curious how much we can play around that. Cavern would be the best draw by far. Mm-hmm. Just Slam Muxus probably wins from there. They could have like Snapcaster. That'd be something to be cognizant of.
I mean, they're thinking about it, which is not a good sign.
Yeah.
Which means that they probably have options, so.
Oh, maybe they're thinking about moving the sword over.
Okay, yeah, that's a thing that can be done. Upkeep. Okay, all right. Game plan activate. I'm going to name Goblin.
It is true that we can no longer Munitions Expert the Venser because it's Pyro Black. So that is relevant. But I think chances are this Muxus hits enough to kill them next turn with the Sling Gang. And I don't think there's a way for them to... Are we dead exactly to V-Click?
We are, yeah. Uh-oh. You paused. Look at this card, Eli. Look at the fireworks going on in the background. We're here to have a party. Let's actually think about this for a sec, right? So maybe we do want to actually play around Vendilion Click here, but they would have probably Vendilion Clicked us on our draw step, right?
Oh, that's true. Yeah.
So...
And they know about the... Yeah, this is probably more like a snap plow,
which I think is manageable, right?
Yeah, that's totally fine.
The Yeah, I've been playing a decent chunk of Among Us, so now I'm like learning like how to speak in persuasive language and things like that, and it big money. Okay, what? No haster though. Okay, not the biggest money, but still like not the worst.
They're still like dead to Sling Gang next turn, I think.
Yeah, that's a pretty good sign.
All right, so I think we get our second copy of Sling because of V-Click.
Mm-hmm.
And Creator Maker for the sword, I guess. How much we got? Seven. We got six mana. We could get Prospector so we can play Sling Gang and Pashlik Mons in the same turn.
I don't think the sword's gonna matter, right? Because they're just gonna die.
Yeah, the sword doesn't matter. So yeah, I think we get second Sling Gang and then Prospector.
I'm content with that. Yes, and then get the one of the two Skirk Prospectors. Okay. And we can't attack. Actually,
I would not attack.
Then we get value off the Sling Gangs and we want to save it for that.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Fine with that. I guess if we get double Sling Gang into play too, that's kind of tight.
Yeah.
Yeah. But
we're not.
What's up?
We are dead to V-Click.
We are, yeah.
I know. That's eight. That's eight damage.
Never mind. We're not.
Right? Yeah, it's eight. Yeah.
Three, okay. Four, five, six, seven, eight. Okay. Whew. I. Good thing I can't combat math here, but either way, I'm going to stick to the hard tell that they probably don't have it because
yep,
they would have done it, right? Like, that's just like a thing. Oh, this is interesting. What are we discarding to the Sword of Feast and Famine?
Oh, yeah, I didn't think about that. I guess probably let's do Prospector.
Okay, yeah.
Because if we draw a land, we can do the same thing with Pashlik plus Sling Gang. And, like, that's our only copy of Pashlik Mons, and these are both our copies of Sling Gang,
mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Whereas we have one more copy of Skirk.
True. I'm content with that, yeah.
I think the next turn is going to be swing all and then post-combat Sling, so they can't plow pre-combat to keep... to like, if they plow Sling Gang in response to the ETB triggers, they can probably survive. So we should just push any amount of damage and then
mm-hmm.
and then play the Sling Gang.
Okay, they do have Snapcaster Mage, which is kind of something that we expected.
Yeah, that doesn't really matter, right? They have to plow Muxus presumably, but then we gain four. Like, gaining four is such a huge deal here.
Yeah. I don't know what other target they could possibly hit. Everything else is just like, how do I explain this? Like, it's redundancy, right? These are all just like one X1s that are in play. So
I guess they need back to basics.
That would be a good one. Then if they go back to basics
and we don't draw a black source.
Yeah.
Okay. But if they go back to basics, then, chances are we might just be able to race anyway.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we could like still attack and then play Skirk Prospector, then play the Pashlik Mons, and then maybe do some stuff.
Well, we could do Skirk pre-combat, then sack a Matron, cast Pashlik, attack with everything, and I'm pretty sure that would still kill them.
Oh yeah, that's optimal sequencing, better sequencing. I like that.
Then you can start like on your way to sacrificing. Okay, that does not matter.
What is this card? Okay, Teferi, sure.
On our way of sacrificing things, we can activate the 4-mana ability on Pashlik.
That's true.
Maybe they're just going to bounce their own Snapcaster? They could bounce Fencer.
I don't know if that does anything. I think they're going to bounce one of our things. They're going to untap all their stuff. You're right. Okay, yeah. That makes sense. All right, so...
So we discard... Yeah, we discard Skirk. Or maybe
it's tricky.
They're gonna have Venser. We also have double Lackey, which is relevant.
Mm-hmm.
I think we can discard Skirk.
Okay, I'm up for that. Yeah, that's fine. I think the Lackeys will do a pretty good job here, just like completely destroying them. So,
because even if they bounce their own Venser, we can. Attack first to force them because they need two blockers to block both the lackeys.
Yeah.
And then we can use the Sling Gang, so they're forced to use the Venser unless they have another plow.
And they can't have like Venser and back to basics and stuff like that, so.
Yeah, exactly.
I guess this does mean that, do I really think they're gonna like Venser the Goblin Lackey? That's kind of interesting. Okay, end step, untap. They didn't have the back to basics, very good. Rishadon port, okay.
Port, nice, any land was good. So I think we pre-combat play the Pashalik off of mountains.
All right, I'm gonna
because if they Venser that, it's fine.
Yes. Well, what's tricky here? Okay, yeah, pre-combat play this. I'm okay with that. Yeah, then I'll play the land.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just going to hope here that they Venser this. And if they do that, then... Okay, they did not. Well, I'm going to move to attacks now.
Mm-hmm.
I think there's no way they don't play the Venser before combat, right?
Yeah, they have to... Yeah. Unless they have a plow.
Attack Star Wars guy.
Yep.
Bang.
And the lackey is going to, or the Pashlik is going to make things trade instead of get eaten.
Yep. Trade in the sense that... So this is fine. This resolves. Trade in the sense that we'll still be dealing damage.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. So they have to do this. Sure.
That's fine.
And they block lackey.
Yeah. If they don't block the lackeys, they're just dead. So.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And then they still take what's
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
So now they're dead to Sling Gang.
And if they do block, they're dead. Didn't finish my sentence, but yeah.
Super. It's nice. Just kind of another. Because even if they had a plow in response to the ETB triggers, yeah. Mm-hmm. Nice.
And I think they knew about the Sling Gang too, so.
They did, from the V-click, yeah.
Yeah, from the click, and then from the... We fetched one off of Matron too, yeah, so.
They knew that was a solid monster.
That was great, yeah. All right, how do you feel about this card?
Very good.
These cards? I don't know about Caracas, actually. That one's good. We'll come back to that one.
I like Needle for Planeswalkers and equipment.
This card?
No, because I think... Chances are that we really want Pyroblast available.
Okay. Yeah, that's something that I've realized is that Chalice of the Void... So generally speaking, when I think of Chalice of the Void, I think of decks that are just like, haha, Chalice of the Void, now you can't play the game, right? But it seems like in these kind of matchups, like, we don't necessarily need to lean too hard in that direction because we're just like... How do I explain this?
We're winning normal games of Magic.
Exactly, yeah, right, it's perfect. But the games of Magic where we can't win normally, like against combo, that's probably where we would bring in something like Chalice of the Void. So.
Yeah, Chalice is almost like I think of it as an anti-LED card more than anything else.
Mm, okay.
So, all right, so
what's weak?
This is interesting. Stoneblade, huh? So
it's been a while?
Yeah, it's been a while.
Wait, hold up, I got this. www.patreon.com/goblinlackgablin.
I do have blue light Stoneblade on that list.
Oh, okay.
My
shamelessly like, plugging.
Like, yeah, I mean, it's like I've got like 40 matchups on there. Chain Brothers the first easy cut, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And then I usually shave on the enablers because this is a pretty slow matchup. So I actually shave like a lackey prospector. And it's almost like we have too much to port in.
Right.
We could shave a pilot.
Okay. Do we want the bolt?
I think we do. Answering Stoneforge turn 2 on the draw is pretty nice.
Yeah, okay.
And also stuff like Containment Priest you want a one-man answer for.
That's a good point. Yeah, Containment Priest seems like a pain. Mog War Marshal, how good is that?
War Marshal, like as you've kind of experienced, War Marshal's pretty good in these slow, like blue-white style decks, right? Like it's good against them because it makes removal awkward and powers up our Trash Master and stuff. I think it's pretty solid.
Sure.
I think we could just... Let's shave a Wasteland for a Caracas. And then we can cut...
I actually like that. Very, very smart pickup.
Let's cut another lackey.
Okay. All right. Off to the races. 7 seconds left on the sideboard clock.
I'm fine with the curve going a little higher here, just because it's I think they're going to be pretty prepared for Lackey post-board, especially. Oh boy.
Wow, do you have faith?
I kind of do. This hand's pretty fine. Like, with the fact that we have the cavern, we have a bolt, and we've port is pretty appealing.
Let me tell you this, right? Remember earlier you said with this kind of deck, you want to have a plan. I'm looking at all these cards, and I actually see a plan, right? This is the end game off of this.
Yeah, this is like win on turn six is the plan.
Yeah. I'm content with this.
Yep.
Obviously, there are certain things that they can do. They can... Oh, we're at 11 minutes going into game two. Wow.
Oh, boy.
They can... Let's play the mountain here. What can they do? They can Vendilion Click and Venser the Muxus, so it's not, like, crazy. But...
Yeah, but it's going to be a little tricky to do that when we're porting them as well.
Exactly. Okay. This is fine.
Right. So we let that trigger resolve, and then we bolt it.
Yep. It's almost like things are lining up just as we had scripted, right? So bolt this. That dies. We untap. They've got Sword of Fire and Ice. Let's go ahead and play this.
All right. More lands, not necessary. I think we port the planes in case they're playing Astrolabe.
Seems reasonable. I like that. I don't think they actually kept a hand without a blue source, right? But I feel like you would definitely, like, if playing a blue deck many times, like, it's just like, you definitely play the blue source out first, so... Oh my god, okay, that's big.
Well,
I accept this.
Oh, Trash Master's good insurance, yeah. All right, we can start fetching. We don't want to, we're going to run out of fetchables because we have our third mountain.
Oh, okay, yeah, I had not thought about that. It's good to be on. Good for that to be on the radar for sure.
Okay. Trashmaster is such good insurance, though.
It really is. I don't think I'm gonna play it on turn four. No.
We're just gonna port them forever until we slam Muxus.
Yes. Okay. Sure.
Oh, yeah.
I accept this. This is fine. Yeah, I'm all just right, gonna go ahead and fetch, and we'll get the third mountain.
Any two drop will play.
Okay, that's fine. I'm okay. I guess I'll do the same deal, right? Yeah. It's kind of funny. Like, I just feel like I'm literally doing nothing and still...
But winning.
Yeah, exactly, right? It's just like, hello? Like, the state of this game. All right, end step. I should do it on upkeep. I know I should. I'm bad.
I don't think there's a punish. So if we draw our third Badlands, we actually run out of fetchables, which is funny.
Okay, that's a good one.
Yep, we can just play Lackey, play the fetch.
Yeah, I don't want to give them the luxury of... What's up?
I guess we... I guess we cavern out the Lackey. Like, it's like 90% sure that they have a...
Force
of Will.
Yeah. The way I think about it is, like, they haven't cast any spells. That means they probably have... They kept it for a reason, you know what I mean? And...
In this turn, we're going to port the Caracas in case we hit a Haste Lord off this Muxus. We want to attack with it.
Your brain is out there in the year 20XX, I'll tell you that much. And then tap this. They get to Astrolabe, that's fine. We will instead just kill them.
Yep.
And they can't use the card. What is it? Back to basics. That doesn't do anything here either. So all in all, I think we're just in a crazy, crazy position. And no, opponent said GG's in the chat. Let me cast the Muxus. Please.
Don't concede.
Yeah. All right. And it looks like they've conceded. It looks like, but yeah. All in all, I mean, okay, look, I think there's a lot of stuff that we learned here in this league. I think that last game was just a really, really, really good showcase of, like, despite the cards not necessarily, like, the cards that we had in our hand didn't look impressive, but there was a lot of, like, thought into what we could do with those cards. Like, it just so happened that Cavern of Souls and Muxus is, like, really good in this matchup because it just gives they can't interact with it, really, right? Like, we're just going to get a bunch of goblins into play and win off that. So, pretty good, like, show there.
It just shows that you know, we had the bull to stop their initial aggression, which was very likely going to be a Stoneforge Mystic, and it was. And if they don't have that Stoneforge Mystic to push out the equipment early, it's really hard for them to kill us by the time we would cast Muxus. So, yep. And also that hand just top decks insanely well. We have mostly lands in our hand. We even drew a bunch more lands and we were still fine. Mm-hmm. But yeah, like our all live draws. And I think that's a huge part of playing Goblins is, but when you look at it hand, it's like, does this hand draw well? And that's the difference between a good risky keep and a bad risky keep.
Yep, for sure.
Looking at your future top decks and that stuff, like, am I playing Pyroblast in this match? And do I have a true red source or do I just have Cavern? If no, this hand's slightly weaker than I might, you know, want it to be. So these are, I think, getting your mana online and under control is almost the number one step of mastering Goblins.
Yeah, for sure, for sure. All right, so looking at just evaluating how games played out today, I think some of the things that we really learned was what the one drops are really good. Legacy is a format about mana, and the one drops are really good accelerating them out. There's just a lot of dangerous synergies that this deck has. Peshalik Mons and Siege Kicking Lieutenant, super strong. Crater Maker, I think, definitely overperformed. It gave us a lot of outs to cards that we would normally struggle with, like Plague Engineer. In terms of the sideboard, I was really impressed by Pyrokinesis again, because remember that our round number two overperformed, killed double Plague Engineer.
God. Yeah.
Nuts. And then I think the other card that, like, I know we didn't draw it in this league, but Pithing Needle was actually something that I was actively constantly looking for.
Yeah, yeah. So I added this needle last second because I heard about this uptick in depths, and we ran into 5 out of 5 Pithing Needle matchups. Is that true?
I think so. Yeah. It was pretty crazy, right? How like this card was just like, even though we didn't draw it, like it was applicable like in most of our matches. And Pithing Needle is one of those cards. It is pretty, you know, it is pretty, yeah, exactly, versatile. It's very versatile, so that's pretty good. Moving forward, I'd probably continue playing the Pithing Needle. The Lightning Bolt was also kind of nice. I mean, it's just like a
it looks really weird, but I'm liking it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I almost wonder if it, I mean, so removal actually matters a lot. The Bolt is one of the easiest ways to just get like something like Goblin Lackey through. I think that's pretty good. So yeah, I mean, the list seems pretty good in general. If there were other cards that you wanted to test out, what would you try out? And
I'm always a little bit unsure on the number of Haste Lords. I could easily play a third Boar Chief and cut the third Pile Driver. That's like my like constantly weighing back and forth on the scales. Main deck Trashmaster would have looked appealing in this league, but when Delver is the accepted best deck, I would really want my third Ringleader over the Trashmaster, because Trashmaster is quite poor in the Delver matchup, right?
Yeah, that 100% makes sense. Yeah.
So if someone's dealing with a more local meta that's less Delver heavy, I think you'd want to get a Trashmaster into your main deck. Other cards I'm interested in testing. That's a good question. I don't know. So the toughest matchup for Goblins is Depths and then really fast combo. There isn't that much super fast combo because there is so much Delver, right? And that's suppressing a lot of the combo decks. So our sideboard's given a little more leniency than it normally is, where normally I'm playing like 2 Mindbreak Traps and I'm playing a Caracas main deck. So if I wanted to hedge for Depths a little bit more, which is my worst matchup, I'd probably play a second Needle, or I've never actually really registered it, but I consider cards like Ensnaring Bridge would be like the nuclear option against Depths. But it's tough when it's just like everything gets decayed or Force of Vigored. So it might just be like the best way to beat Depths is just play more copies of Caracas.
Yeah, no, that totally makes sense. Yeah. I know one of the things that we were thinking about was just like playing the third Pyroblast potentially over the Pithing Needle. That's another flex slot that you could consider based on the metagame too. So
yeah, if you're expecting a lot of snow, you can play the third Blast. But like, if you look at the way the deck would sideboard against snow, you're bringing in your relics because they're really good against Uro. You're porting in 2 Blasts because they're good against Back to Basics, Oko, you know, Uro to some extent. And then you board in, I usually board out a Wasteland or 2 and board in the Caracas, because if you can just hold off Uro forever, then you can win with your late game of Muxus and stuff.
Yeah. Caracas is really good against Uro, 100%.
Yeah. So the combination of like Caracas plus Blast for a back to basics is usually where you want to try to set up against Snow. And then I go back and forth on whether or not I want Bolt against Snow, just because post board, there's usually two Containment Priests and then 2 to 3 Engineers. So that's somewhere I don't have the testing and reps against Snow at the moment, against current builds of Snow, because it's just not that popular in leagues, at least when I'm playing. I've played like maybe 2 times against Snow in the past like 45 matches or something. I know that based on watching your stream, I know that that's a little unusual, but maybe it's just a late night Eastern time. People don't want to grind Snow.
Yeah, I don't know. No, I totally understand that. I mean, it's one of the decks that like requires a lot of tuning and things like that, so not surprised. But yeah, all in all, I mean, that is pretty good. I'm pretty happy with how the deck performed today.
Yeah, I think all the cards got their little moments to shine. Like Chain Ruler showed up and was good. The Jump Home was good. Like I liked that all the one-ofs kind of showed their purposes. And I think the pile drivers were nice in that. The question I get asked a lot is like, why am I playing 3 pile drivers? And the answer that I've kind of become happy with is the idea that pile driver has a very narrow window of effectiveness in a lot of matchups. And so you don't want to have to matron for pile driver. You usually want to matron for War Chief or another burst damage card to let the pile driver deal even more. But if you matron for pile driver, it's usually a turn too slow or too telegraphed. And so I want to naturally have the pile drivers and then save the matrons for more value or more potent effects overall, if that makes sense.
Makes sense. All right. Well, Eli, thank you so much for joining us for this episode of the Master Series. For anybody else, be sure to check out channelfireball.com. Thank you for sponsoring today's video. Like, subscribe, you know, show them that you are invested in the legacy. Yeah. All right, guys. That's going to be it for me. I'm going to catch you guys next week. I'll see you guys for the next video. Bye.